Shalom, 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 Mashpacha, and unto the whole house of Yasharal, along with all the strangers, foreigners, and sojourners who are found within the gates of Yasharal, seeking the Most High Yahuwah in the mighty name of Yahusha. Amen. Today is indeed that day. Today is Yom Kippurim. Amen. The day of atonement. And I just wanted to bring this word, this quick word. I prayed about it, of course, as I do all of my scripture studies, all of my discerning of the word of Yahuwah, amen. And it is very important that we talk about atonement, that we talk about the sacrifice that Yahusha made, that Yahuwah made. Amen. It was Yahuwah who allowed his only begotten son to venture into this world, to come into this world, to take the place of sacrificial animals like bulls and goats, because he was no longer pleased with that. Amen. So Yahusha came and he gave his life. He laid down his life. We're gonna get into the scriptures in just a moment to come. But as I was saying, we need to talk about Yom Kippurim. We need to talk about Passover, unleavened bread, first fruits, the harvest festival, the Feast of Trumpets, the Feast of Tabernacles, or in gathering. Amen. But this feast day, being a very high Shabbat, very high Sabbath, amen, is important because we need to understand, research, get on our knees and pray and seek Yahuwah fervently about his sacrifice, about the sacrifice of our Mashiach. Amen. Because if it were not for him, if Yahusha had not come, if Yahusha was not first prophesied about in the book of the prophets, in Yahshua Isaiah, and then he comes in the renewed covenant, of which so many people try to discredit, say the renewed covenant, or what you may know as the renewed, the New Testament, is invalid. These people who try to invalidate, make a mockery of the renewed covenant, are in actuality condemning themselves to the below place, to a place of destruction and eternal torment, because you are trying to bring to ruin what Yahuwah did, and whom Yahuwah put his name in, and who came in his father's name. Amen. Yahusha says that he come in his father's name. He came in the name of Yahuwah. He did not make of himself any reputation, but he came because he loves us. This is why today Yom Kippurim is so important. Now, on yesterday, Wednesday, I would hope and pray that we got everything prepared. I would also say that, just as a suggestion, that today, as far as it being Yom Kippurim, the Day of Atonement, that we're keeping our children out of school, and we are sitting them down along with other loved ones who are in this truth with us, and we are reflecting and we are acknowledging what Yahusha did, what Yahuwah did, and furthermore that we are also fasting, we are afflicting our beings. This is not my word, this is indeed the word of Yahuwah, for he said that we shall afflict our beings. And whichever soul does not afflict their being that does work, serve our work on Yom Kippurim on this day, that soul, that person shall be cut off from his people or her people. So what I'm basically getting at is the fact that Yom Kippurim is important for that very reason, so that we don't get cut off, so that we don't end up away from Yahuwah. That is the whole reason. We do not, should not allow anyone into our space who is going to make a mockery of the word of Yahuwah, for one, and what Yahusha did. Now, once again, I just wanted to say that little tidbit, but it was on my heart. It was on my being. Again, Yom Kippurim for me is a day that I know perhaps around this time Yahusha gave his life. He laid down his life so that I may have a way unto the Father. Had he not done that, none of us would have a way unto the Father. None of us would have another mediator. None of us would be able to seek or be granted salvation if not for his, Yahusha's, sacrifice. Amen. Now, we're going to be reading out of, hope you got your book of scriptures, word of Yahuwah handy. We're going to be reading out of Yashayahu, Isaiah 53, Yaukanan John chapter 15 verses 1 through 14. We're going to dabble a little bit in Yashayahu, Isaiah chapter 9, and I'm going to start this thing off full-fledged with Matthathiyahu, Matthew chapter 26, and as an important reason why I wanted to start it with Matthathiyahu, Matthew 26. So again, on this Yom Kippurim, I hope that your families are safe. I hope that you guys are safe and in good health. I hope your children are safe and in good health. And again, we are taking this time to afflict our beings, fast, no food, no water, for this sunrise to sunrise observance of this sixth appointed time of Yahuwah, amen. Again, I know everybody or others may have different calendars, and I'm just going by the way Yahuwah showed me. Amen. Sunrise to sunrise, because there is no darkness in Yahuwah, so we should not be following darkness to honor him. Amen. Let us get into a quick prayer. Humbly, Father, I come before you with humility, selflessness, that you would indeed enlighten me that there is absolutely none of me and all of you, that we may be receptive to what your word has to offer. Humbly, Father, we all honor you. We all show humility, abstinence, that we lift you up on this day, because Yom Kippurim is indeed a day, a high Shabbat, that none of us need to forget, that we all should acknowledge, because it is the day that Yahusha willingly laid down his life, that we may have a way unto you. Humbly, Father, I pray a great reprimand swiftly would come upon me and my household if I come in error of your name. And finally, Master, I pray that you would open up the windows of the Shamayim of the heavens and pour upon us a blessing to the readers, hearers, and doers of your word, that we won't have room to receive. And finally, Master, as always, it is in the mighty name, Basham Yahusha, we pray. Amen. Okay, Mashpacha, family, friends, loved ones, readers, hearers, and doers of the word of Yahuwah, this is Yom Kippurim. this day. Let us reflect. Let us analyze the word of Yahuwah. Let us take its majesty for what it is and do what he commands us to do. Amen. The reason I wanted to start with Matthatiyahu Matthew 26 is because of one particular verse. And this is why we definitely need atonement. We should be overly thankful for what Yahusha did in laying down his life for us. And he made an atonement for us and our sins, our iniquities, our transgressions, that we may have a way unto the Father. When we look out on the world itself, from our houses, even when we're at work, we see a world, and that world has been spoken of, and what is spoken of as it pertains to this world is that it's going to pass away. Nothing will be left, because Yahuwah is going to do a new thing in his time. But the fact remains, Yahuwah said that this world is going to pass away. So we have got to make the choice of whose side we want to be on. Do we want to be on the side of righteousness? Or do we want to be on the side of unrighteousness and lawlessness? Do we want the gift of indignation, that of which Sodom and Gomorrah received? Do we want that same gift of indignation and wrath, the same that Babylon received the first time and is going to receive again? Amen. When we look out on that world, as I said, we know full well those of you, them, they, he and she and me who understand clearly and know the name of Yahuwah, that the Master has spoken. And he has said this world will pass away. So it is better that we get our ducks in a row, that we cross all our T's and dot all our I's. Because the great and terrible day of Yahuwah is coming. It is even at the door. This is why we need atonement. Because there will be no one who can stand in that day who will be able to survive the fierceness and the fire of the indignation of Yahuwah. This is why we need to remember and observe throughout all our generations, throughout all our dwelling places, the feast days of Yahuwah. This is why it's important that we do not add nor take away from the word of Yahuwah, but do everything that is commanded therein. Debarium Deuteronomy 28 is the reason why. Blessings and curses. Amen. Now, the reason I said about Matthatiyahu Matthew 26 is because of verse 41. The reason why we need a mediator in Yahusha, the reason why we need or need it for him to come and willingly lay down his life and make an atonement for us, is because of Matthatiyahu Matthew chapter 26 verse 41. And it reads, whereas Yahusha, I believe he is speaking to Kappa, Peter. In verse 41, he says, watch and pray that you enter not into temptation. The spirit, Ruach, is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. Watch and pray that we enter not into temptation. But what did we learn in the previous scripture study? Chaos, destruction, is that we need to be vigilant. We need to be of sober minds, because the enemy Hashatan, the devil, he is walking about as a roaring lion seeking whom he can devour. How does he begin to devour us? Through temptation. It doesn't matter what the device is that is based on our temptation. It is basically temptation that he uses. If Yahusha had not come into this world, Mashbacha, we would be going along with this destruction without a lifeboat. What are those round things called? A life, whatever the thing is, the round donut looking thing. We wouldn't have none of that. When Kappa asked Yahusha to come on the water with him, and he began to look at all the chaos in the world, and Kappa Peter began to sink, well, Yahusha pulled him out. If Yahusha had not come into the world and willingly laid down his life, we would not have that helping hand. Amen? We would not have a way unto salvation and the tree of life. So this is the meaning, this is the reason behind Yom Kippurim, the Day of Atonement. Because our ruachs, our spirits, are willing, but the flesh is weak. Doesn't matter if it's based on promiscuousness, alcohol, gambling. There are people who have taken lives of other people who are sitting in prison right now. The flesh is weak. And when we think about our flesh, we think about our carnal mind. Amen? We think about doing the things that we want to do versus what Yahuwah has for us to do. Amen? So this is why Yom Kippurim is so important. This is why obeying the Torah of Yahuwah is so important. So we got that out of the way. We got Matthew 26:41 out of the way. And we know and understand what Yahusha is saying. He says to us, watch and pray that we enter not into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. What does Yahuwah says in Proverbs? He says, lean not into our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge him, and he will direct our path. What else does he say in Mishaya Proverbs? He also says that the heart of a man devises our plans, but it is Yahuwah who orders our steps. See, when we devise a plan and we try to bring that thing to fruition on our own, oh, I don't think what you devise is going to come to be how you had it planned out, because without Yahuwah, it never goes as planned. Amen. So let us open up to Yeshayahu, Isaiah. We're going to just read a couple of inserts from Yeshayahu, Isaiah chapter 9. Amen. We're going to read just a couple. We're going to read verses 6 and 7. Then we're going to jump over to Yeshayahu, Isaiah 53. So, Yeshayahu, Isaiah chapter 9, we're going to read 6 and 7. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty All, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end, upon the throne of David, and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forevermore. The zeal of Yahuwah of hosts will perform this. Amen. So here in Yahshayahu, Isaiah chapter 9, verses 6 and 7, we are already seeing where Yahusha is spoken of, that he is said to be on his way. Said a child is born. Amen. And the government will be upon his shoulders, and there will be peace to no end. So doesn't that sound like that's the side we want to be on? When we do self-inventory, and I have done it, and I it's like I do it every single morning. I lied to you now because I had a dream. I'm going to tell you this dream real quick. In this dream, I had a black eye. And on that black eye, there was a scar. When I looked this dream up, the dream meant that I can say that when you have a dream similar to that, having a black eye in the dreams means you can see the evil, not only in other people, presumably, but you can also see it in yourself. So that's what self-inventory is, when we acknowledge the evil within ourselves and we stomp it out. When you know you shouldn't have that last drink, when you know you shouldn't be with your coworker after work, whether he or she, knowing there may be some flirtatious activity going on there that may end up being something that it shouldn't. When you know you shouldn't be in a place where there's criminal activity going on that may cause you to do something that you shouldn't do. Or even if you are already involved in said activity and you are seeking the life of another. Amen. So yes, every morning I can see the evil in myself. What did we just read from Matthew 26:41? The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. So all praises unto the Most High Yahuwah. In the name of Yahusha, I'm glad that he showed me that. So I need to be able, I need to be on a dedicated visual lookout at all times, like he said, watch and pray. Because I don't want to be put in the position to where I'm going to sin against Yahuwah. Amen. For all of what we have accomplished through Yahuwah, whatever righteousness he has allowed us to accomplish, if we now go away from that righteousness unto wickedness or return thereof, everything that he allowed us to do, all the righteousness that we have performed, everything that, or let's just say, all of whom we have spoken to that he allowed us to speak to in his name, shall not be remembered, and we will die in our iniquity, in our transgressions, excuse me. Amen. So the side that we want to be on is that of Yahusha. He has already said in Yahuchanan John 14:6 that he is the way, the life, and the truth. No man comes unto the Father but through him. You won't get to Yahuwah no other way. Amen. This is why Yom Kippurim is so important. All of the feast days of Yahuwah and their ordinances therein are important. There was a reason why Yahuwah said to afflict our beings on Yom Kippurim. There was a reason. Look what happened to Yahusha. Look what they did to him when we read scripture. They beat him. And still he opened not his mouth. Amen. They hung him from a tree. And they mocked him. saying that he healed others. He saved others, but now can't save himself. If he had chosen to get down from that tree, where would we be? We definitely wouldn't be walking around here with the name of Yahuwah on our foreheads and in our hands. I can tell you that for damn sure. Yahuwah is patient, is kind, and compassionate. What love is this that Yahusha laid down his life for us? I've said in many prayers unto Yahuwah that I am not worthy. And I can think back and honestly say that perhaps he got tired of me saying that. But I was honestly trying to be truthful unto him. No BS. Because when we go through our afflictions, they really, or the affliction itself, really teaches us right from wrong. And when we are going through that pain, we learn that though Yahuwah bruises us, it is indeed an act of compassion. And it was an act of compassion that Yahusha did not remove himself from that tree. It was an act of compassion that he did not put an end to what they were doing to him, how they were beating him, how they were hurting him, how they were flogging him. He did it all because he said he loves us. Amen. Let us go over to Yahshua, Isaiah 53. And we're going to read. Who has believed our report? And to whom is the arm of Yahuwah revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant and as a root out of a dry ground. He has no form nor comeliness, and when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. When he was being beaten, where were we? We hid our faces. We didn't speak up. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of Yahuwah, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Can we now grasp the importance of Yom Kippurim just by reading verse 5? That he was wounded for our transgressions because he told his father, I love them. Yahuwah says that I love them. Amen. So he bore the chastisement upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. This is why Yom Kippurim is so important. Because had it not been for what he did, again I say, where will we be? Let us continue reading verse 6. All we like sheep have gone astray. We've all fallen off the beat. I know I have. We've all fallen off the beaten path. This is why I say I wake up every morning and I know that I need Yahusha. I know that I need Yahuwah, because the days are evil and temptation is always right around the corner. And if we are not fervently of a sound mind, looking and watching and praying and keeping the Torah of Yahuwah, the evil one will come in. And before you know it, or before we know it, we would have transgressed the laws of Yahuwah and found ourselves at odds with him. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned everyone to his own way, and Yahuwah has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. This is coming out of Yeshayahu, Isaiah 53, verse 7. This is before the renewed covenant. The prophet Yeshayahu is speaking of Yahusha. Yahuwah gave him a vision and told him what was going to happen. This is why we are reading out of Yeshayahu, Isaiah 53, because Yahuwah gave the prophet Yeshayahu a vision of the Mashiach. He was oppressed, he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before the shears is dumb, so he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison, from judgment, and who shall declare his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living. For the transgression of my people he was stricken. Amen. For the transgression of my people, he was stricken. Now remember, I said in the previous scripture study, the word of. This is speaking of native born to Yasharal and Sojourner alike. We've got to remember Yeshayahu Isaiah 56. Amen. He was stricken from prison and from judgment. I'm sorry, he was taken from prison and from judgment. Who shall decree his generation? For he was cut off out of the land of the living for the transgression of my people. And he was made, and he made his grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was there any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased Yahuwah to bruise him. He has put him to grief. When you shall make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of Yahuwah shall prosper in his hand. Yet it pleased Yahuwah to bruise him, an act of compassion, because it was because of Yahuwah bruising Yahusha that we have a way unto Yahuwah. He has put him to grief. When you shall make his soul an offering of sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of Yahuwah shall prosper in his hand. Did not Yahusha rise with all power in his hands? Yes, he did. Verse 11, he shall see of the travail of his soul, and he shall be satisfied. By his knowledge shall my righteousness, or righteous servant, justify many, for he shall bear their iniquity. Verse 12, therefore will I divide him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he has poured out his soul unto death, and he was numbered with transgressions. Oh, I'm sorry, he was numbered with transgressors, and he bare the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors. Again, this is why Yom Kippurim is so important, because Yahusha made intercession for us, the transgressors, because many are the sins of us. Amen. Again, if it had not been for Yahusha, where would we be? This is that time where we can sit on the patio, on the balcony of our homes and dwelling places, go to the park and just sit in nature and think about this actual act of compassion. Yahusha laid down his life for us. It is adamant that we teach this to our children. It is adamant that we teach the word of Yahuwah to our children. They need to be able to know and to learn and to comprehend who their Savior is, who their Mashiach is, the deed that he performed, that he did out of love and compassion for us. He did not see us. He did not want to see us come to desolation and destruction. As we learn in Kappa Peter, it is not the will of Yahuwah that any, not one, should perish. But he, Yahuwah, wants everyone, every single soul, to come to repentance. He don't want nobody to die. He doesn't want nobody to perish. That his word says it. Amen. So Yahusha is prophesied or prophesied or spoken of in Yashayahu Isaiah 53, Book of the Prophets, Yashayahu Isaiah chapter 9, 6 and 7. Amen. This is why Yom Kippurim is so important, that we fully understand what Yahusha did. And when we fast, no food, no water, it is like we are in concert or audience with him. Because he did not eat nor drink either, because they tried to make him drink vinegar and he drunk it not. Amen. Someone who was righteous, is righteous continually, that is how they treated him. How many times that we have gone astray to and have treated people or mistreated people the wrong way? Again, based on our carnal mind and our way of thinking. I'm gonna raise my hand first. I'm not gonna exclude myself because I have done it. Again, I say this is why I need Yahusha and why I observe the Day of Atonement, Yom Kippurim, for what he did. He made atonement for me. And what did he say? He said, You are my friend if you do all that I command you. And if you love me, keep my commandments. Amen. So I'll tell you this one thing too. I'm at the job. My coworker asked me, how do you remember all this stuff? My simple answer was this. Yahusha laid his life on the line for me. It is my duty to remember it. It is my desire, my want to remember it, because he paid the ultimate price for me. And what way do I acknowledge his sacrifice? What is a good way to acknowledge his sacrifice? Keeping his commandments, learning of him daily, speaking of him, constantly renewing my mind and becoming better than I was the day before. Amen. This is why Yom Kippurim is so important. Because Yahusha laid down his life and he made a way for us to have passage unto Yahuwah and the tree of life. Amen. Let us jump over to Yahuchanan, John chapter 15. We're gonna read verses 1-14. And we're going to see what Yahusha says. Amen. He says, I am the true vine, and my Father is a husbandman. Every branch in me that bears not fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Verse 3. Now you are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. What was the word? The word was, keep his commandments. And now we are clean. This is not my word. This is his word. Now you are clean. We are clean through the word which Yahusha spoke unto us. Verse 4. Abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can you except you abide in me. He laid down his life. And when he did such, Yahuwah exalted him above everything and gave him a name above every name. That at the name of Yahusha, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Yahusha is indeed the son of Yahuwah. Verse 5. I am the vine, you are the branches. He that abides in me and I in him, the same bring forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Yahusha is telling us clearly. Without him, nothing can be done. Amen. Verse 6, if a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. So the wicked will walk around thinking that they are winning, not knowing that when the branch is broken off from the true vine, it takes a little time for it to wither. But it will wither. It will die because your life supply, your life support has been cut off. Again, this is the whole reason behind fasting and afflicting our beings on Yom Kippurim, because we do not want to be cut off. For we will slowly wither away and die. Amen. Verse 6, one more time. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered. And men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. Verse 7, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will, whatever you want, and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father esteemed, that you may bear much fruit, so shall you be my taught ones. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Continue you in my love. If you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. Verse 11. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. And the creme de la creme. Greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you. And what did he just command us to do? Love one another as he loves us. Amen. Yahusha laid down his life. And we've truly got to understand that he didn't have to. The word says he willingly laid down his life. He came here knowing what had to be done. When I wake up in the morning, knowing of the dream of the black eye and the scar over it, I know what has to be done. I know I have to be of a sober mind. I know I have to stay at attention. Not tightly wound, but just at attention. Because the days are evil. This is why we must abide in the love of Yahusha, of Yahuwah. This is why Yom Kippurim is so important. This is why all of the feast days are so important. This is why the commandments of Yahuwah are so important. Because if we are not abiding in the love, in the word of Yahuwah, then the world shall swallow us up whole. Amen? And before we know it, the thief shall come and take away all that we have. Or let me rephrase that. Before we know it, Yahuwah will come like the thief in the night. And we will not be prepared in any ways. And we will be left behind. Amen. So Yom Kippurim is a day beheld to the highest. Because Yahusha gave his life that we may have a way unto him and Yahuwah and the tree of life. That we may be able, having kept his commandments, done the things that he loved, enter into the city, the set apart city. Amen. That we have not changed his word. We have not added or took away from it. We do not bring his name to ruin by calling him Yahlordgodjesus. Amen. But we take what he gave us in his word as he gave it to us freely. We meditate on it. We teach our children about it. And when he sent us out, we speak of him with humility. Amen. Let us think on the things that Yahusha did. The sacrifice made by Yahuwah. Because the bottom line is, he did not have to do it. But it was out of intense, immense love and compassion for that of which he created, that his compassion renews every morning. Yom Kippurim is important. All of his feast days are important, yes. Yom Kippurim, Passover, are the two high of high Shabbat days. Amen? The next week you're going to be venturing into Feast of Tabernacles. That's when we'll be tabernacling with Yahusha. And Yahuwah willing, he'll let me do a little something on the Feast of Tabernacles coming up. But the Yom Kippurim is important, Mashbacha. This is something that we all should reflect on. We all should gather ourselves and reason together about the word of Yahuwah, his sacrifice and what he did, how he allowed Yahusha to come into this world. Yahusha said, greater love has no man than this, than a man lay down his life for his friends. Yahusha is standing in front of that bullet every single day of our lives. He is protecting us every single day of our lives. If you woke up this morning, then he is protecting you this day. If you wake up tomorrow, he will be protecting you tomorrow. If you wake up on Shabbat, Saturday coming, you are being protected by Yahusha. Amen. Let's go back to verse 12 real quick. I'm going to my seat, but let's go back to verse 12. This is my commandment, that you love one another as Yahusha loves us. Verse 10, keep you my commandments If you shall abide in my love, even as I abide in the love of my Father, or the commandments of my Father. Amen. What you ask shall be done unto you. Amen. Verse 6. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch, a broken off branch, and is withered. And men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. That is our fate. Either we will serve Yahuwah as it is the whole duty of man, or we will be with the world, and it will pass away, and those who are with the world will pass away with it. Let us continually think on Yom Kippurim and the sacrifice made by Yahusha, that we continually abide in him, for he is the true vine. Let us abide in his commandments. Let us think on these things. Let us look out onto the world, onto the day, this day, Yom Kippurim, and reflect and be truly receptive to what Yahusha did. To be truly receptive that the love of Yahuwah renews every morning. That we are given chance after chance to get right. And that should be our choice, to get right, to be with Yahuwah. Because the below place, where eternal darkness, destruction, and desolation is, as it is described in the book of Kanuk Enoch. Nah, I'm good, player. I don't want to go there. I don't want to go there. And I'm pretty sure y'all don't want to go there either. So let us guard our hearts, guard our minds, seek Yahuwah fervently in the name of Yahusha, that hopefully when all this is over with, we shall stand before him, and he is going to say unto us, servants, well done. Well done. Mosh Makar, I want to thank everyone for, tuning in. All praises unto the Most High Yahuwah for allowing me to bring his word. Again, as always, I pray a great reprimand will come upon me and my household if I have come in error of his name. My whole purpose here on Yom Kippurim is to assemble with everyone listening, that we may be receptive to the word of Yahuwah, that we understand what he did for us. Greater love has no man than this, than what Yahusha did, as he willingly laid down his life. That for all of us who believe on him, we endure to the end and we will be saved. Amen. Now I got a special song coming up in about 2 minutes that really focuses on, or is really the foundation. It really speaks to what Yahusha did, to what Yahuwah does every single day by waking us up. And I hope y'all enjoy. And until next time, I bid you peace. And I pray that Yahuwah shall give his Malachayim charge over you, over your families, over all your loved ones and friends, that no evil or sickness shall befall you. That he would hide his face from all of our iniquities and blot out all of our transgressions. That he would hold us in the palms of his hands, touch us in a mighty and a special way, and keep us strong physically, mentally, and spiritually. That he would cast us not away from his presence and take not his set apart Ruach away from us, but allow his set apart Ruach to rest, rule, and abide in us. That we are shown all truth of the set apart names of Yahuwah and Yahusha, to know the righteousness therein and thereof, to show ourselves approved by studying his word, line upon line, precept upon precept, here a little and there a little, that we may come to the truth and understanding that there is only one way unto Yahuwah, who is salvation, and that's through Yahusha, with obedience and repentance of all transgressions. It is and always will be in the mighty name of Yahusha Basham. Yahusha, I pray. Amen.
Oh.